सुपर कंडक्टिविटी वॉज डिस्कवर्ड इन 1911 बाई के ओन्स, बट द थियोरी एक्सप्लेनिंग दिस सुपर कंडक्टिविटी फिनोमेनन वॉज अवेलेबल इन 1957. दिस लॉन्ग डिले इन डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द थियोरी इंडिकेट्स हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट वॉज टू फॉर्मुलेट द थियोरी एक्सप्लेनिंग द सुपर कंडक्टिविटी फिनोमेनन. जॉन बार्डिन, लियोन कूपर एंड जे रॉबर्ट श्रीफर पुट फॉरवर्ड देयर theory which is known as BCS theory to explain the superconductivity phenomenon. According to BCS theory, the superconductivity arises from a subtle interaction between free electrons and lattice vibrations, that is phonons. So the main reason according to BCS theory behind the superconductivity is electron-phonon interaction. To arrive at this statement, Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer used some of the observations. One observation was, very good conductors at room temperature such as copper, silver, gold do not turn out to be superconductors even at very very low temperatures. But some poor conductors like lead, niobium at room temperature may exhibit the superconductivity when taken to the very low temperatures. So poor conductors get transformed into the superconducting state easily, and good conductors at room temperature, it is not possible to transfer them into the superconducting state. So we know the poor conductors at room temperature means higher electron phonon scattering, because electron phonon scattering is the main reason behind the resistance, higher value of the resistance. So poor conductors get transformed into the superconducting state at low temperature. Poor conductor means higher electron phonon scattering, strong electron phonon scattering, and therefore this electron phonon scattering has something to do with the superconducting phenomenon. Metals which are good conductors means the electron phonon scattering is comparatively less in case of metals. They do not get transformed into the superconducting state. Poor conductors are transformed into the superconducting state. So Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer from this commented that this electron phonon scattering must have something to do superconductivity. Another important observation considered by Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer was that varying the relative abundance of different isotopes has an effect on the critical temperature. Isotope means what? Isotope means nuclides having identical nuclear charge but different nuclear mass. It was found by them that samples with lighter nuclei, that means fewer neutrons, will have higher value of critical temperature. A smaller nuclear mass means larger amplitude of lattice vibrations. So smaller the mass means larger will be the amplitude of lattice vibrations, and therefore greater will be the electron phonon scattering, because larger the amplitude means more is the chance for the electron to get collide with these vibrating ions, and therefore more will be the chance of scattering. Smaller the amplitude, less will be the chance of electron getting scattered. So smaller nuclear mass means larger amplitude of the lattice vibrations and hence greater electron phonon scattering. And what Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer observed? They observed that samples having smaller nuclear mass, that means lighter nuclei, have higher critical temperature. Means it is easier to transform the isotopes having smaller nuclear mass into superconducting state. So the isotope effect is another evidence which indicates the relation of superconductivity with the electron phonon interaction. So from these two important observations, the poor conductors have more chance to get converted into the superconducting state, and samples with lighter nuclei have higher value of the critical temperature. Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer arrived at the statement that the superconductivity arises from a subtle interaction between conduction electrons, that is free electrons, and the lattice vibrations, that is phonons. So So electron phonon scattering, if it is high, then there is more chance that the material will get transformed into the superconducting state. Greater the electron phonon scattering, more is the chance of the material getting transformed into the superconducting state. So according to Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer, electron phonon interaction has something to do with the superconductivity. As the temperature increases, due to the increased amplitude of these lattice vibrations, the electron phonon scattering also increases, and that leads to increase in resistance. Now let us see what happens when we reduce the temperature below the critical temperature. When the temperature is reduced below the critical temperature, the thermal energy associated with this lattice vibrations will be very small, and as a result of this, the amplitude of the vibrations will also be small. When the electron enters in this lattice, due to the attractive force between the electron and this positively charged ions, these positively charged ions are pulled towards the electrons, and this results in a positive region, a strong positive region created over here. The attraction of these electrons to the wake up positive region is greater than the electron-electron Coulomb repulsion, and the two electrons form a bound pair, and this bound pair is called as the Cooper pair. So now once the temperature is less than critical temperatures, electrons will not move individually alone, but they will travel in the form of the pair. Once the Cooper pair is formed, lattice vibrations cannot scatter this pair of electrons easily. Lattice vibrations can scatter this pair of electrons only by breaking that pair, and this will require energy Eg equal to 3.5 KTC, where Eg is the binding energy for this Cooper pair. And we have reduced the temperature below the critical temperature, and as the temperature is less than the critical temperature, the thermal energies associated with this lattice vibrations will not be sufficient to do this, will not be sufficient to break the Cooper pair, and therefore Cooper pair will move undeviated, unscattered. Cooper pair cannot be scattered by the lattice vibrations at the temperature less than the critical temperature, and therefore resistivity will become zero. All the electrons moving from one end to the other end will reach the other end. Electrons in good conductors like gold, silver move so freely in this lattice that little electron lattice interaction take place. So the electron phonon interaction is very less in good conductors, and therefore there will be no pairing of electrons, because pairing of electrons requires strong electron phonon interaction, and therefore this good conductors at room temperature do not show the superconductivity even at very low temperatures. So this is how Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer explained the superconductivity phenomenon, and this theory is called as BCS theory. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to the channel so that you will get timely intimation of new videos uploaded to the channel. Thank you very much.